everyone, and welcome to the Rundown for Thursday, April 9th, 2020. I'm Lauren Lindsey.
And I'm Julia Smith. We hope all of you are staying healthy and not too bored.
We hope that the Rundown and Flyer Minutes presented by the Media Arts class is keeping you up to date with what's going on in the Loyola community.
Zoom classroom has been an adjustment for a lot of us, but Mary Catherine Bernard tells us there's more than just getting online every morning.
There's been many changes to adapt to in the last few weeks. For Loyola students, one of the biggest changes is not wearing a uniform to class. Let's see what some of our students have decided to wear.
I normally wear hoodies and then like pajama shorts and my glasses because I just get up and I don't feel like changing, and then they're really comfortable, so.
I like to wear my uniform for a couple reasons. One is being like, I put it on in the morning, that gets me in my school mindset. I'm like, okay, you know, I'm not in bed anymore, my pajamas. Get to school and start working. And then it also helps to keep a sense of normalcy whenever like everything else has been turned upside down. Like I'm no longer going to school with my friends. I can't see and talk to them every day, but I guess I can wear my uniform. That's as close to normal as it's gonna get.
For Zoom classes, I just wear a t-shirt and shorts or pajama pants because it's what I sleep in and it's comfortable.
In class, I like to wear my chef outfit because I was truly inspired by the movie Chef by Jon Favreau. Have you seen Chef, by the way? If you haven't seen it, it's on Amazon Prime for free. It's fantastic, truly.
Love the new uniforms. This has been Mary Catherine Bernard.
Thanks, Mary Catherine. You gotta look good, even if it's only on a square block on a computer screen.
No doubt, we are all counting down until we are able to get back to life as we knew it only a few weeks ago.
Carolyn Harrison finds out from students what they're looking forward to once that happens.
All of us are ready for things to go back to normal. Let's see what the first thing some of our students will do once the stay-at-home ban has been lifted.
I am most excited about going back to the theater and going back to rehearsals after quarantined. And I'm also so excited to go see my friends again and be able to hang out with them every day.
What I'm most excited for when quarantine ends is to finally get to see all my friends again and go somewhere that isn't my house.
Oh, the first thing I'm gonna do is go see my grandparents because I haven't seen them since the whole coronavirus has started. And I'm also looking forward to seeing all my friends.
The first thing I'm gonna do after quarantine is hang out with my friends and probably get coffee.
Hopefully things will go back to normal soon. This has been Carol Ann Harrison.
Thanks, Carol Ann. I know there are plenty of things I'm looking forward to doing again.
We had some more of our athletes receive recognition on the All-City soccer teams. Here's Wes Barlow.
Last week, we told you about the All-District teams, but now the All-City teams have been announced. On the boys' All-City team, senior Peter Vancherry and junior Bruno Palmieri were named to the first team, and seniors Andrew Flinnigan and Matt Montour were on the second team. On the girls' team, Callie Matlock was chosen as Player of the Year for the second straight year, as she helped lead the Flyers to the state title game once again. Defender Chloe Dean and goalkeeper Morgan Kleinpeter were the other first team selections. On the second team were Aaron Campbell, Kennedy Jarrett, and Faith Davis. Coach Mark Matlock was also named Coach of the Year on the All-City team.
It's no surprise the Flyers dominated once again. Congratulations.
Thanks, Wes. All right, it's time to see who has birthdays coming up.
Here's John Michael Guzin with the list of students who are getting a little bit older in the next week.
Hi everybody, here's the list of those who will be having a special day very soon.
On Friday, it will be the birthday of senior Eli Cooper and junior Thomas Carroll. Monday will be junior Sky Lang's birthday. Tuesday, the birthday list includes freshman Blaine Jeter and sophomore Corin Jackson. Wednesday's birthdays will be senior Griffin Valuis and sophomore Kason Gray.
Be sure you blow out all the candles.
That's going to do it for this edition of The Rundown. Have a happy Easter break.
Don't forget to watch the Flyer Minutes every day, and we will be back for another Rundown next week.
Stay safe and healthy.
See you next week.
You know what this Sunday is. Actually, let me... You know what this...
Even though some sports... Even though we have some sports and... Even though we have many sports... I don't know.